Let me first read this question. A three-phase 50 hertz generator is rated at 500 MVA 20 kilovolt with subtransient reactance of 0.2 per unit. The generator supplies purely resistive load of 400 megawatt at 20 kilovolt. The load is connected directly across the terminals of the generator. If all the three phases of the load are short-circuited simultaneously, we have to calculate the initial symmetrical RMS current in the generator in per unit on a base of 500 MVA 20 kilovolt. After reading this question, you can make this circuit diagram. In this circuit diagram, you can see that there is a generator of rating 500 MVA 20 kilovolt. Subtransient reactance of the generator is J0.2. There is a resistive load of 400 megawatt operating at 20 kilovolt. And this resistive load is connected across the terminals of the generator. In the question, it is written, if all the three phases of the load are short-circuited simultaneously, it means you can make this diagram. All the three phases of the load are short-circuited simultaneously, and the examiner is asking to find out the initial symmetrical RMS current in the generator. It means that we have to find out this current in per unit on a base of 500 MVA 20 kilovolt. You can see here I have written 0 ampere. The meaning is the load given by the examiner is resistive load. The nature of the load is resistive, and during the fault the resistive load cannot feed the fault current. That's why I have written 0 ampere here. The complete fault current will be fed by the generator. That's why the examiner is asking the initial symmetrical RMS current in the generator. There are three names for IF. IF is called fault current. IF is also called subtransient current, or you can say initial symmetrical RMS current. So you can see after applying KVL, you can write this equation, IF equals to EG double dash upon J0.2, and if you know the value of EG double dash, which is the subtransient internal voltage of the generator, if you know EG double dash value, you can find out the answer easily. This subtransient internal voltage of the generator is always calculated from the pre-fault circuit. The meaning of the pre-fault circuit is the circuit which is available to us just before the fault. So just before the fault, the circuit available to us is this. This is the pre-fault circuit, and from this circuit, we have to find out the value of the subtransient internal voltage. The examiner has told that there is a resistive load of 400 megawatt operating at the terminal voltage of 20 kilovolt. So from these specifications of the load, we will first find out the current in the load, or you can say we will first find out the current which is flowing in the circuit, and after applying KVL, we will find out the subtransient internal voltage of the generator, and then we will put the value of subtransient internal voltage here to calculate the value of the fault current. So there are three steps. The first step is, from the given specification, find out the current flowing in the circuit. The second step is to find out the subtransient internal voltage. And the third step is to find out the value of fault current by using this formula. Let me start with the first step. The first step is to find out the value of the current in the pre-fault circuit. To calculate this current, we will use the specifications of the load. The load is specified in this way. The actual power drawn by the load is 400 megawatt, and the actual terminal voltage is 20 kilovolt. The examiner has given that the base values. The base power is 500 MVA and the base voltage is 20 kilovolt. By using the actual values and the base values, we can find out the per unit values. The per unit value equals to actual value divided by the base value. So the per unit power drawn by the load equals to actual value of the power drawn divided by the base value of the power. So the per unit value of the power drawn by the load will be 0.8 per unit. The per unit terminal voltage will be the actual terminal voltage divided by the base voltage. So 20 by 20 will be 1 per unit. So per unit terminal voltage will be 1 per unit. In per unit system, we can use this formula P equals to VI cos phi. Already we have calculated the per unit power drawn by the load. The per unit power drawn by the load is 0.8 per unit. The per unit terminal voltage is 1 per unit. Because the load is resistive in nature, that's why I have written cos phi equals to 1. We can calculate the value of the current drawn by the load in per unit. The current drawn by the load in per unit equals to 0.8 per unit. In the second step, we have to calculate the value of the subtransient internal voltage. To find out the subtransient internal voltage, apply KVL in this loop. After applying KVL in this loop, you will get this equation. In this equation, we will put the value of VT, I and XD double dash, and we will get the value of subtransient internal voltage. I am assuming the terminal voltage as a reference voltage, that's why I have written 1 angle 0. Because the load is resistive in nature, therefore I have written the current drawn by the load in phasor form as 0.8 angle 0. Put the values of VTI and XT double dash here, and this subtransient internal voltage will be 1.0127 angle 9.09 degrees. After calculating this EG double dash value, put this value here in this equation and you will get the value of the fault current in per unit. Fault current in per unit will be calculated in this way. Fault current equals to EG double dash upon J0.2, and after calculation you will get 5.06 angle minus 80.91 degrees. So here your answer is complete. If the examiner has told you to calculate the actual fault current, then you can extend the calculation in this way. You need to calculate the base current. The base current equals to base power divided by under root 3 into base voltage. The base power is 500 MVA and the base voltage is 20 kV. And after calculation, you will get the base current in kiloampere. The base current is 14.433 kiloampere. If you know the per unit value and the base value, you can find out the actual value. So the actual value of fault current will be 73.03 kiloampere. Let me tell you some key points regarding this question. The first key point is, if the generator is operating at no load or the load is not clearly specified by the examiner, then assume the pre-fault internal voltage of the generator, or you can say assume the subtransient internal voltage of the generator equals to 1 per unit. The second key point is, if the generator is operating under loaded condition or the load is clearly specified by the examiner, then calculate the value of the pre-fault internal voltage, or you can say subtransient internal voltage. In this question, the load is clearly specified by the examiner, or you can say the generator is operating under loaded condition. So you need to calculate the subtransient internal voltage of the generator. The third key point is, if you are writing the formula of power for three phase system in per unit, then use the formula P equals to VI cos phi. Do not use P equals to root 3 VI cos phi, your answer will be wrong. The fourth key point, I have already told that initial symmetrical RMS current is called subtransient current, or you can say fault current. So in this way we have completed all the key points regarding this question.